from Sense.
First of all, magandang gabi po sa inyong lahat. Nice to see everyone. Mike pala. Good evening po sa inyong lahat. Magandang gabi sa inyong lahat. Thank you for joining me here. Lalo na kay Sen Risa, thank you so much. Thank you for everything. Free at last. At last. After 6 years, 8 months, 21 days. And this is my 2,454th day. So I'm released after 2,454 days. Hindi ko talaga ma-describe ang feeling na nangyari na yung pinakahihintay ko. But with your permission, I think some of you would want to ask questions later. But with your permission, meron po akong babasahin muna ng statement. Can I do that? Though it took too long, I never lost faith that my inevitable freedom will come. Alam niyong lahat kung gaano tayo katagal naghintay ng nagtiis, na may pananalig na ang katotohanan at totoong mustisya ay magtatagumpay. But the counting of the years, the months, days, hours, minutes, seconds, the milestones in my own life, in my family's life, and in our nation's history that I have missed by being unjustly detained cannot be counted. None of those can fully express how much and how long I have longed to be able to say the words, "Finally, the truth has set me free." Yes, it's always the truth. It's always for the truth. And that's why I'm now set free. Wala sigurong sapat na mga salita ang lubos na makakapaglarawan sa damdamin ng isang inosenteng inapi. Sa kabila ng pighati at paghihirap na dulot ng pagbabaluktot sa mismong batas at prosesong ipinaglalaban, ay patuloy na nananalig, nananampalataya, at umaasa na darating din ang panahon na mananaig ang katotohanan at tunay na katarungan. Every moment was a test, and every single second was a fight to rise above the sorrow, the fears, the uncertainties of the future, and even, to be honest, the temptation to be overcome by hate and vindictive thoughts. There was always that temptation. Lahat po yun nilabanan ko. Hindi ko isusuko ang aking pagkatao at pagiging tao. They may have taken years of my life, but they will never take my humanity. Ang mundo ay puno ng mga taong buktot ang kaluluwa at makasarili sa harap ng pagdurusa ng taong bayan. I will never be one of them. Every second, every minute, every hour, every day, every month, and every year of the last 4,054 days was a struggle. But the one thing I can honestly say is that I never allowed myself to even entertain any regret. No regrets. Yes, I wish things turned out differently, but these are things that were beyond my control. But for the things that were, what I did, how I reacted, and my reasons for fighting for those who were victimized and cannot speak for themselves, I have no regret. As I appear before you today, 6 years, 8 months, 21 days after I peaceably surrendered myself to the authorities, it is one of my greatest achievements in my career and in my life to say that not only did I survive all these years of persecution and unjust detention, I came out stronger than ever, with an even stronger commitment to truth, justice, human rights, democracy, and the rule of law. These are not just words to me. These have been my lifeline. These have been my life before, during, and after my unjust detention started. Kayo po ang aking ipinaglaban. Kaya maraming salamat dahil ako rin ay inyong ipinaglaban. Maraming salamat po sa mga panalangin niyo at sa walang kapagurang pananalig niyo sa katotohanan. Diyos mabalos, mabuhay ang sambayan ng Pilipino at ang Pilipinas. Thank you, Sen. Risa.
All right, we are opening up the floor for the questions. First to ask is Jair Boliedo from Rappler.
Good evening po, ma'am. First
Good
po,
evening.
Congratulations po sa sa legal victory niyo po na ito. Ang question ko po, ma'am, nabanggit niyo po sa statement niyo, yung mga persecutors niyo po, you will never be like them. Although, ma'am, malaking bagay po itong petition for bill, motion for reconsideration niyo po, for bill niyo na natanggap, hindi pa rin po tapos yung kaso. Yes, dahil ongoing pa rin po siya. Pero masasabi niyo po ba na legally vindicated na po kayo with this recent victory?
Yes. Hindi ko pa buong na babasa yung decision. Although I'll try as much as possible to really avoid talking about the merits, because as you said, as you acknowledged, hindi pa tapos talaga yung kaso. Baka ma-sub judice tayo. Pero, you know, I never lost faith. And we have always been confident about the merits of my case. And even when we first filed my petition for bail, before, matagal na kami nag-file ng bail. We were already confident of the merits of that. It's just unfortunate that the previous handling judge denied it. And so when we filed our motion for reconsideration, I think it was in June 13, we remained to be confident that the merits of our application for bail will be recognized and upheld by the court. And it took this long. It understandably, because the judge is a new judge, so we had to review the entire voluminous records of the case. We were actually expecting a ruling as early as September, because as I said, we filed the motion for reconsideration in June. So medyo tumagal, understandably again, and ito nga. And I think, kasi nakita ko nga, although hindi ko pa nga nababasa, It was a thorough and extensive discussion of the merits of our motion for reconsideration. So it is a legal vindication, because we were always confident, although I cannot further make any comment about that. I have a lot to say about that, but you know, it's still pending. The case is still pending. Hindi pa po tapos. This is bail, this is provisional liberty, and this is definitely a great gift from the Almighty God.
Ma'am, last question lang po for me. Yung Marcos administration po, sinasabi po nila po at ulit na the justice system is working in the Philippines. And in response to your latest legal victory, Justice Secretary Crispin Remulla, this is po yung statement niya. It just shows the independence of the judiciary, what I've always been saying from the beginning, and that they are free to decide as they please, as they deem fit. Any reaction lang po sa statement po ni Justice Secretary?
I actually thank the administration for respecting the independence of the judiciary and the rule of law. Ganun lang naman. As somebody said, the legitimacy of the judiciary lies in its independence. It's just like, you know, the legitimacy of the government or the legitimacy of the executive department or of the government, the elected officials lie in the votes of the people. So judiciary, it's the independence. Without the independence of the judiciary, then we cannot say that the judiciary really has its legitimate standing in the scheme of things. So tama yan na sinasabi, na pinakita ngayon na we have a working system. Kasi matagal na nga namin hinihintay yan. You know, when the Marcos administration came in, there was some hope at least in my case, that justice will be, you know, will happen. And kasi nga, I always knew that while the former president was in power, I will not be set free, because my persecution was his project. So how can I be set free during his term? So nung nagbago ngayong administrasyon, may pag-asa talaga at umasa talaga ako ng umasa na makakamit ko yung hustisya at malalaman natin yung katotohanan about my innocence. But again, ayaw ko na muna dagdagan yung mga ganyang statement. Medyo na sobrahan na nga. Thank you.
Thank you, Sen. One question po for Sen Arisa. Any message po for Sen Lila now that she's free and that you finally met each other again?
Well, you did it, Lila. Konti na lang, konting-konti na lang. And napakalaking vindication ito sa buong opposition. Itong vindication sa'yo. Kasi sa lahat natin, ikaw talaga yung sumalubong sa pinakamatinding dagok galing sa dating presidente. Ikaw talaga yung sinirang kuri niya, sinubukang gawin. Ikaw talaga yung wineponize niya yung buong legal system para lang parusahan ka, kasi ikaw yung unang nag-imbestiga sa kanya. You continue to speak truth to power. At kahit sinubukan niyang tambakan ka ng ng mga, ako na magsasabi ng peking kaso, hindi naman ikaw nagsasabi. Na-survive mo lahat yan. Na-survive mo yung stroke. Na-survive mo yung hostage taking. Hindi ka tumigil magsalita sa mga issue. Libo na siguro yung mga handwritten letters mo from Krami. And here you are. Here you are. So itong pagpapayag sa wakas na makapost ka ng bail at yung napipinto mong ganap na paglaya. Parang sumilip na ulit yung sikat ng araw. At alam natin, kahit napakatagal ng naging gabi mo, napakatagal ng gabi ng maraming kababayan natin, once sumikat yan, dahil sa mga ginawa mo, hindi mapipigilang kumalat yan. So we're all so happy to have you with us, and we all love you very much.
And Risa. Lagi ka rin nandyan. And you also write me regularly. Nagsusulatan kami niyan.
Thank you, Sen Risa. Thank you, Sen Lila. Our next ask question is Andrew Alimario from CNN Philippines.
Hi, ma'am. Good evening po. Andrew po. Hi, ma'am. Almost 7 years in detention. You've mentioned about surviving persecution. Do you plan to go after your persecutors? Do you plan to sue them? And your message to former President Rodrigo Duterte.
First, yung message ko kay former President Duterte, isa lang sabi, well, God forgive him and God bless him. Yun lang muna ngayon. Marami pa akong pwedeng sabihin sa kanya. Pero wag muna. I don't want to be I don't want to be political sounding tonight, because this is a moment of joy. This is a triumphant moment for me. So I as much as possible, I want to be gracious. And so yun na lang muna. God forgive him and God bless him. He knows what he did to me, I suppose.
any plans of countersuing or what or going after them?
Pag pinag-uusapan namin yan ng mga abogado ko, wala muna kami mga specific na mga pwedeng i-announce about that. There's always that option, but as to definite plans, pinag-uusapan yan. Of course, there will be, you know, I need to do something also. A lot of things to do. Hindi po madali, napakahirap, masakit talaga kung ipakulong ka na wala kang kasalanan. And it's a matter of justice that those that need to be held accountable should be held accountable.
Sorry about that. Senator, I know you said that you have no regrets over what happened, but what was the lowest point in those 6 years, 8 months, 21 days, and what pulled you through?
Well, isa sa mga ano is, of course, the personal life, sa family life, kasi may mga milestones sa family na mga na-miss ko. Like, for example, when my son, Vincent, passed the bar exams, and I was not allowed to attend his graduation. Masakit para sa akin yan. And then it's always painful to me that I'm not with my mom, my 91-year-old ailing mom, who's now bedridden. So isa nga yan sa mga una kong gagawin, umuwi ka agad ako sa Bicol para makapiling ko ang aking ina. And we haven't seen each other for more than 4 years already. So itong homecoming na to, this will give her the best Christmas gift. I definitely would want to see her already. Siya excited na rin siguro. Kanina nung nasa court ako, pinakausap sa akin ng brother ko sa cellphone niya, yung mommy ko. And she's waiting for me. And so, yun, masakit sa akin yun na mawalay ka sa pamilya. And of course, yung mga nawawala, mga wala na sa mundong ito, mga kamag-anak, mga kaibigan. Yung nawala si Pinoy, I was so down and I could not even pay my last respects, and some other friends, some other allies like si Sec Dinky. Masakit din sa akin not being able to say goodbye ng mga nawala na dito. And I'm of course updated with the news because meron naman akong newspapers and my staff would send me printed copies of news articles, online articles, and nakikita ko naman ang mga nagiging developments, and rather there are good news, there are bad news, there are sad news, and all that. But really, those more than 6 years of being alone, because I've always considered my detention, my unjust detention, as both a curse and a blessing. It's a curse because I don't deserve it at all. It's a blessing because there are many things also that I've learned while in detention. I became more prayerful. I became closer to the Lord because, you know, I've got so much time to pray, to read the Bible, to reflect, to do contemplative prayer and all that. So those are blessings. And then I have learned to appreciate mundane things, small things in life. Pag umuulan, lumalabas ako sa quarters ko para tingnan yung, para lang obserbahan yung ulan and all that. And then I have stray cats in my quarters. That's why I was so sad. I was almost crying when I left Kamkrame today or Custurdo today because I had to leave the cats there. They've been my companions. They kept my sanity intact. So, yung mga ganun po. It's a purifying experience. Pero pag may mga bisita ako, and then they would say, we can imagine what you feel. And then I'm tempted to say, no, you can never imagine what I feel. You will know it only when you go through this also yourself. But I've developed a very routinary daily life in my detention. It's a very routinary daily life. And my problem now is how to adjust. Kasi magiging iba na ang aking routine from now on. Thank you so much.
Thank you, San Laila. Any more questions? Mara from Straits Times.
Hi, San Laila. Mara Cepeda po from the Straits Times. Ma'am, you've always been a very vocal figure in the Philippine opposition. What do you think, ma'am, are the implications of your release today for the Philippine opposition now? Your presence into the open world, I'm sure, do you think it would it help invigorate the opposition forces, especially now that, you know, kakaunti lang po sila ngayon sa Kongreso? What's your message for the opposition figures and the opposition people in the opposition movement who are, of course, very happy that you're released?
First of all, my fight for my advocacies will continue. And my advocacies are really shared by the opposition. Fight for the truth, fight for justice, fight for rule of law, fight for democracy, fight for sovereignty. And definitely I'll be working side by side with the opposition. I remain to be an opposition. I'm with the opposition because we share the very same advocacies, ideals, and visions for this country. And hindi naman natapos yung pakikilaban ko sa mga advocacies ko habang nakakulong ako. I never stopped. And now that I'm free, I'm even going to work harder for those advocacies.
Ma'am, if there's one thing that you want the international community to remember about your legal victory today, what would it be po?
Well, it is a vindication of my innocence. And I thank the international community for closely monitoring my case. They've been there, and it helped a lot. It means a lot to me that the international community, almost from day one, has been monitoring the progress of my case. And many of them, many personalities, foreign dignitaries, and also foreign organizations have been releasing statements calling for my release. And this is vindication. And I will further work for complete vindication because hindi pa nga tapos itong kaso na to. I want people to know the truth of my innocence. I want the people to know how it happened. I want the people to know who are behind it. So in due time, because that's vindication. Kasi maraming napaniwala noon. So this is my opportunity. Because, you know, they destroyed my life. And that's why I'm going to rebuild my life now. They destroyed or ruined my name, my reputation. Now that I'm free, I'm going to work hard to redeem my name. And vindication, complete vindication, is the key. Thank you.
Thank you, Sen. Any more questions? All right. Before we end, are there anything else that Senator Laila and Senator Risa would like to add?
Pasasalamat lang po sa inyo lahat. Hindi niyo ko pinabayaan, kayo, my friends, my allies, my supporters, my sympathizers, for believing in me all this time, for your continued faith in me. Maraming maraming salamat. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Sen. Thank you, Sen Lila. Thank you, Sen Risa. Okay, that ends our presser for today. And thank you so much, friends in the media.
Also is formal. Well, you were asking me. Pa alam kung talagang diretso na paplanuhin pa namin because foremost kasi iniisip ng mga kasama ko is my security. So we have to be doubly careful.
Okay po, kung wala na pong questions, last photos na lang po and then we can wrap up.
In jail. He's asking about my health. I said I have health issues because I'm no longer young. In fact, I turned senior citizen or dual citizen in jail already because I was arrested when I was 57 and now I'm 64. So I nag-birthday ako ng pagka senior citizen ko nasa ano na, and I kept praying really that this Christmas won't be inside jail, that the celebration of Christmas. Grabe talaga yung dasal namin because as I told you, we were expecting the resolution on the MR as early as September. So last month, so every time nga nag-hearing yung sa court ay na umaasa kami na ilalabas na ni judge yung ruling niya. And this today kasi is the last day, last hearing for the year. Ang next setting kasi is January na. So we were really expecting na ngayon na ilalabas because of that. Na, as I said, September pa lang umaasa na kami na lalabas na yung ruling. And we have always been confident that I will be granted bail because we believe and we are sure of the merits of our cause.
Okay.
Ito talaga, dito nawawala.
Oh!
Senses na pong nakatayo naman.
Mabuhay si Layla!
Mabuhay!
Mabuhay si Layla!
Mabuhay!
Mabuhay si Layla!
Mabuhay!
Alright po, maraming salamat po.